Let's take a minute out to introduce my lovely wife and law partner, Chris Merrill. Good morning.
Good morning, Tom, and Happy New Year, WDBL listeners.
It is good to be back on the air. It's been a, during the holidays, you get mixed up as, what day is this? Well, today is Saturday.
Yes.
It's good to be back on the air. We took a break last weekend, which is very nice, and it's a nice opportunity to gather with our very close family members, you know, not as large a group as normal, but we had certainly our closest family, the people we see on a day-to-day basis, and it was a very special holiday season for Christmas and New Year's, and we hope the same for our listeners out there.
Exactly, yes. We hope that each of you had as good of holidays as possible, considering the circumstances, and importantly, we wish each of you an absolutely wonderful new year with many blessings for you and your family, and hopefully many blessings for our country and this world, considering everything going on.
Amen. And, you know, there's always traditions that go on in Christmas time. And one for us is we always go to church with your mom, United Methodist Church in downtown DeLand. And we're thinking we were not going to be able to do that this year, but they did open up for a church service. It was a limited number of people. We had reservations. There was social distancing. They did many things differently this year. But it still was a very, 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 very special church service.
Very moving and very special, and we are so thankful that we were able to and that they continued having it, because you're absolutely right, Tom. They put in, of course, they did it differently, did all the appropriate things, but as many churches did not have the traditional Christmas Eve services that they usually do. And so it was a blessing that they did have. They continued with it at First United Methodist. And my brother, of course, has been singing a solo for over 20 years on Christmas Eve. And of course, that is always special to us as well. And we're glad that that was able to continue.
Yes, and by the way, at the church, they took our temperature on the way in, and again, we had reservations, so we might normally go to that service on Christmas Eve, and it would be jam-packed, but there was just a limited number of people in there, and I always want to remember, because I feel certain by next Christmas things will be back to normal, but I always want to remember Christmas at a time of COVID, and it was different because we couldn't gather with as many friends and family members as we wanted to, as a lot of our listeners out there were unable to.
Exactly.
But it kind of made it all the more special, and simply because it's an opportunity to count your blessings. And one of those blessings is to gather with family members from far and wide. And me and you this year, we could not do that. But even the limited was special, and it's going to make it all the more special next year when we're able to get back to this gathering of family from all over the country.
Exactly. So to you listeners out there, whatever yours did look like this year, your celebrations of the holidays, we hope that it was as memorable for you as it was for us. And Tom, yes, that would be certainly the wish and prayer for everybody, is that next holidays this time, that things are more back to a, well, let's say this, a new normal.
New normal. And speaking of things that we miss this year, because every year we go out to Epcot and we do the candlelight processional. We very much love that. And of course, we could not do that this year.
Exactly. That was one of the programs that simply did not happen, as in others. And so, again, hopefully in 2021, they will resume it.
Well, we know a lot of people are ready for 2020 to be over. We're all ready for a better 2021. And God willing, I feel certain that that's going to happen for us and our listeners out there and this country.
That would be absolutely wonderful. So let's all keep that as our positive forward thinking for 2021 for all of us.
Yes.